Excellent, excellent, excellent. Hi there, Andrew.
Andrew, you look exactly, I'm Joe. You look exactly like one of our mission designers.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, we're looking at you like that looks just like Chris.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Yeah, man.
Hi.
Bryce,
nice to meet you guys. So, Dead Rising 4.
Yeah.
Tell me about it. What's going on? Where are we now with Dead Rising?
So we're 16 years after the first one. Mm-hmm. Frank's 54.
Oh, wow.
And he's aged incredibly well. And he's gone back to Willamette because, as luck would have it, there's more stuff going down to Willamette. He's got to figure it out.
All right. Awesome. So we are playing again as Frank in this one.
Yes.
Awesome.
And it's not a remake.
Okay.
Not a remake.
It's 16 years later.
Yes.
Okay. Excellent. Kind of an Evil Dead kind of feel to that. So can you talk about some of the new content that you guys are adding into Dead Rising 4?
Oh, yeah. So the big thing for us is we're adding exosuits into the game.
Okay.
A way for Frank to power himself up even more than he did before.
Wow.
And we're going to be introducing stuff, not right now at E3, but also Combo Me is what we're kind of calling it, where you can now combo on top of this exosuit with incredible things in the world.
Oh, wow.
The other thing about the exosuit is it's really going to allow you to experience the world differently than any of the other Dead Risings. You can smash cars, rip parking meters out of the ground, rip signs off walls, use weapons as bigger weapons as environmental destruction goes around.
Okay, awesome. Now, with Dead Rising, it seems with each game, you guys get more absurd with it. How absurd are we getting with Dead Rising 4?
Oh, we're going crazy. We push the number of zombies as crazy amounts. Like Joe was just saying, thousands on screens, more weapons, more combos, and a bigger world than ever before. So we're really pushing the boundaries as far as we can with our engine.
One of the cool things we have in our game is because we've set it in the holiday season, and that opens up a whole new weird world of combo, right? So like if you're doing a game in the summertime, this, I'm going to find candy canes to put in your crossbow lying around, that
That's
kind
true.
Of thing, right? So a lot of holiday stuff, so the combo weapons are just ridiculous.
Awesome. Can you talk about the world? What is the playground that you're letting us play in?
So the world is Willamette, Colorado.
Okay.
You go back, set in a nice little town. There's, you know, military base. There's a place where people live. There's the old town. And, of course, the massive mall. I never say it right. It is the Willamette Memorial Megaplex. It's hard to say, easy to read.
Say that 10 times fast.
And it's a huge mall. So we've kind of rebuilt the mall from where it was before.
Okay.
Massive, updated, and built just in time for humanity to collapse.
Oh, lovely. Perfect timing.
Yeah.
Awesome. So can you talk a little bit about the crafting that we'll be making death machines, you know?
Yeah, well, we really wanted to make our game more accessible and quicker to craft and quicker to do things. In the past Dead Risings, you would have to go to a crafting table to build your items. Now you can craft on the fly. We didn't want to restrict the players. We've also separated out our inventory system. Past Dead Risings, one inventory. We've now separated them out to thrown, melee, and ranged weapons. So you can carry more weapons and combine more things.
Okay, awesome. Awesome. You know, your guys' game is excellent because it's so approachable. I have a lot of friends that are like, oh, I don't play video games. Like, here's a game with zombies. Just kill them. Like, how do you guys create such an approachable game?
Well, we had a great foundation to start. This is the 10th anniversary of the Dead Rising series, and the first one really set the tone. And we've just been building on that tone, and bringing back Frank West is a character that people love.
Right.
And part of the reason I think people love Frank is we call him the unlikely hero. He's the everyday kind of guy.
Right.
And as Joe loves to say...
The way to describe Frank to a lot of people is that he can do the really cool moves and stuff, but he never quite sticks the landing. He kind of lands badly, takes an upper step, lands on his butt, you know, that kind of stuff. And it doesn't take itself too seriously.
Right.
Some games need to take themselves really seriously. We are not that game. We take ourselves... seriously, as a craft and a fun experience.
Of course.
But it's fun.
Yeah.
And we don't try to write all the humor into it. What we do is we give you the tools to create your own fun.
Right,
you can play it straight, you can play it weird. It's your choice. And that's what Dead Rising is all about. And that's why it works, because you can play it however you want it.
I mean, you let me wear a giant Lego head riding a little tricycle ramming into zombies, so...
Well, one of the things we have in the game... because it's Frank and he's a photojournalist.
Yes.
A lot of camera use,
right?
So you're taking taking pictures to find answers to the clues and the mystery you're trying to solve. We also have selfie mode. And the selfie mode is the thing that we put in the game that that we knew was going to be, you know, it's going to be okay. He's going to do selfie. Everybody does selfies.
Right.
But it's so funny now because Frank does the selfie with this really high-end camera, holds it out, and you can change your expression to you're like, making stupid faces while humanity collapses behind you in the worst and best selfie ever.
Right.
And so we do a lot of that stuff, and that kind of, you know, that's the kind of thing that people really pick up on and love.
That's awesome. Can you go into more detail about photography? Because
yep.
I'm one of those few people that really liked the photography in the first one.
Sure. Why don't you?
Yeah. Well, that's really Frank's signature weapon is his camera, and
right.
that's what we really wanted to bring back. And that's really the driving force behind our story as well, and solving the mystery as you go along. Frank uses his camera all through the game to try to find out what's happening, why it's happening. We've added special photo filters to add to the puzzles in the game as you're going through. But he's always reflecting and he's always discovering. And that's one of the great things about Frank as well. He's not a know-it-all.
Right.
He's going along the ride for the ride with the player, and it really feels that way.
If you ever watch CSI,
of course,
you know
yeah.
when they turn the light on,
mm-hmm.
and it's
yeah.
super weird. It's like,
yeah.
it's like, okay, what happened here? And they flip the light. I was like, oh, right. There's a lot of that in the
okay.
game. You can see, oh my God, someone was murdered, dragged across here, and that's a zombie's gone that way. He uses the camera to figure that stuff out. And what's cool about that mm-hmm. is there's lots of optional side missions that you can, oh, I can use my camera, find this kind of hidden thing, and unlock something cool, unlockable in the game.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to, but it encourages use of the camera. And that's Frank's thing.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes sense. People seem to be really gravitating towards
awesome.
That.
Awesome. Now, Frank's coming back.
Yes.
So is there anyone else coming back to this game?
Well, we're not telling you everybody right now,
mm-hmm.
but there is a few other characters that have come back.
And some okay. Easter eggs.
Yes.
Okay.
And some Easter eggs.
Easter eggs.
Yes.
Oh, lovely.
Which may or may not have something to do with Capcom.
Oh,
so that's
ooh.
Great.
Oh, exciting. Excellent. Now, speaking of Capcom, you guys had an awesome, hilarious DLC last year.
Yes.
You guys create a lot of content for your games, but you always put fun
yes.
in front of it. It's kind of silly to ask, but like, why? Why do you guys always go for the extra push of just hilarity, absurdity, and full-sail entertainment?
I think because people want it. You know, if we made something and no one wanted it and they didn't buy it, they didn't think it was cool, we wouldn't make it anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of the stuff that we put out, and we do a lot of user research, and stuff we put out people love.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the expansion stuff that we did with Super Ultra last time, people
yep.
went crazy for that kind
right.
of stuff. And so if the crowd wants it, we will service the need of
mm-hmm.
the crowd. But it's important to keep the series fresh.
Right.
Right? And to keep you know, when you finish the game, there's more fun stuff to do. We want, and then people come to expect that from us now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm just going to add one thing.
Yeah, yeah.
I think with society right now and R-rated comedies coming out, some of the biggest films in the last couple of years, it's really showing that
right.
comedy is here to stay, and mature comedy is something people are really looking for now.
Mm-hmm.
Not the softball stuff that they're used to seeing all the
right.
time. So.
It's interesting because with Dead Rising, you guys are celebrating your 10-year anniversary. You guys have kind of been like the pillar in the ocean with the tide going in and coming out. You guys are still there, still making games, still making the same quality of great games with it. What's it been like seeing the scope of gaming change?
Wow. That's pretty
Great
deep,
question.
Man. You know what? I think that every game and every game company has their specialty and their niche. And, you know, I've seen some unbelievable games at the press conferences here, and I want to play them all.
Mm-hmm.
But everyone has a position to play.
Right.
And, you know, with Dead Rising, our position is, yes, it's a zombie apocalypse,
right.
but it's apocalypse with kind of quotes around it, right?
Right.
It's pretty absurd.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that... I think, like, just like I said, like, we have found our niche with this one particular title that people really like.
Right.
And we're
going
to continue to push that forward.
Yeah. Awesome.
May
now,
not answer your question or not, but...
Now, it's Dead Rising 4. It's the fourth installment. A lot of people, you know, may want to jump into this game, but they might be like, oh, it's the fourth one. Am I going to be confused? What's going on? Or zombies? Can people jump into Dead Rising 4 and still have the same amount of fun?
100%.
Yes.
We're also making sure we're doing a nod to the past and making sure anybody that's jumping into the game now
mm-hmm.
will be able to understand what happened in the past. But you don't have to get involved in this. It's a new story, new campaign for Frank,
mm-hmm.
and Frank's changed a lot, so we're bringing him back and reintroducing him a bit while we're still giving the nod to the past and making sure everybody appreciates all of that stuff.
You see with movies all the time, right?
Mm-hmm.
You see movies that have been around since the 60s, and they go away, and they come back, and they've been redone with a new cast.
Right.
And it works, because games have to evolve.
Right.
You can't just keep serving up the same burger year after year after year. You have to put new things out for people. And I think that's what we've done with Dead Rising. We've focused on the stuff that people love. We've added some new stuff, and we've improved some stuff.
So, I think so, yeah.
Thousands of zombies. Like, we still look at it, we go, how are we doing this? How are we rendering this? And it just works. It just works.
Awesome. Well, I cannot wait to play this game. Guys, thank you so much for hanging out with me.
My pleasure. Thank you
for
having
me. Pleasure.
Thank you, man.
Thank you guys so much. And thank you guys for hanging out with us. This has been a fantastic time here at the Shack News live stream. E3 2016, our 20th year anniversary here. So we're here hanging out at the South Hall at Shack News, his booth. We're going to be hanging out for a little bit longer. I think we still have a little bit more content coming your way. So if you guys just sit real tight, we're going to jump right